Episode number 83. Meanwhile, Carrie Dow and Azuya by a narrative, we must leave our three friends to themselves, and follow the Duke of Buckingham, and his guide through the labyrinths of the Louvre. 12 George Villiers, Duke of Buckingham. MME. Bonacieux and the Duke entered the Louvre without difficulty. MME. Bonacieux was known to belong to the Queen. The Duke wore the uniform of the Musketeers of M. de Tréville, who, as we have said, was at evening on guard. Besides, Germain was in the interests of the Queen, and if anything should happen, MME. Bonacieux would be accused of having introduced a lover into the Louvre, that was all. She took the risk upon herself. Her reputation would be lost, it is true, but of what value in the world was the reputation of the little wife of a mercer? Once within the interior of the court, the Duke and the young woman followed the wall for the space of about 25 steps. This space passed, MME. Bonacieux pushed a little servant's door, open by day, but generally closed at night. The door yielded. Both entered, and found themselves in darkness. But MME. Bonacieux was acquainted with all the turnings and windings of this part of the Louvre, appropriated for the people of the household. She closed the door after, took the Duke by the hand, and after a few experimental steps, grasped a balustrade, put her foot upon the bottom step, and began to ascend the staircase. The Duke counted two stories. She then turned to the right, followed the course of a long corridor, descended a flight, went a few steps further, introduced a key into a lock, opened a door, and pushed the Duke into an apartment lighted only by a lamp, saying, "Remain here, my lord Duke. Someone will come." She then went out by the same door, which she locked, so that the Duke found himself literally a prisoner. Nevertheless, isolated as he was, we must say that the Duke of Buckingham did not experience an instant of fear. One of the salient points of his character was the search for adventures and a love of romance. Brave, rash, and enterprising, this was not the first time he had risked his life in such attempts. He had learned that the pretended message from Anne of Austria, upon the fate of which he had come to Paris, was a snare, but instead of regaining England, he had, abusing the position in which he had been placed, declared to the Queen that he would not depart without seeing her. The Queen had at first positively refused, but at length became afraid that the Duke, if exasperated, would commit some folly. She had already decided upon seeing him and urging his immediate departure, when, on the very evening of coming to this decision, MME. Bonacieux, who was charged with going to fetch the Duke and conducting him to the Louvre, was abducted. For 2 days no one knew what had become of her, and everything remained in suspense, but once free, and placed in communication with Laporte, matters resumed their course, and she accomplished the perilous enterprise which, but for arrest, would have been executed 3 days earlier. Buckingham, left alone, walked toward a mirror. His musketeer's uniform became him marvelously. At 35, which was then his age, he passed, with just title, for the handsomest gentleman and the most elegant cavalier of France or England.